the main purpose of this video is for adorable beings like Prince, is this Prince? And Pasha. Show Pasha. These are my beautiful twinny little dogs, Prince and Pasha. And I made this video because I struggled while preparing to fly with them. So this, I hope, will help you make it, help you easier. Okay, repair it so it's not cut off. Like back, yeah. Okay. The first thing we did was we called the airline immediately and asked for that specific flight, what were the requirements, like the height, length, width requirements of the pet carriers. And this was so difficult to find because my dog's height and length are not naturally the same, I guess, as other Shih Tzus or small dogs. Keep quiet. Okay, so check Pet Smart, check Pet Value. They didn't have our dog size, so that wasn't good. But they do have quite a lot of variety. Okay, where we found it was Global Pets. Global Pets. Oh, I love Global Pets.
You're tired also. Hi, Biden, stop it now.
Oh, I thought you were doing it. Yeah, right.
You're
standing
up.
Why didn't
you do anything except
for sitting there?
You didn't dress.
You asked
to
sit there. You're
sitting there.
No, no. You said come sit here. This is why I don't like making videos.
You didn't tell us.
Okay. Pet Smart, Pet Value, Global Pets, Canadian Tire, Walmart, Amazon, etc. Look at all of these things until you find the right one. Because airlines these days are strict. They don't want your pets to be uncomfortable. No animal cruelty. They want your pets to be flying VIP. Okay, so make sure you fit the requirements. Height, length, width. Double check, double check, double check. The whole 2 weeks we had the wrong carrier. Then we had to switch it. Then we had to find the right carrier. And then for a second we were going to put them in the hole where, like, you know, they go under the plane.
And then we didn't.
No, and then we bought the box. Keep quiet. Then we bought the box. And then we found out, which is very important, that dogs with flat noses
can't fly under hoses.
Cannot be under the plane because they can die. Or like something like that.
So. Oh yeah,
because they'll be under pressure.
Okay. Now with your pack.
Okay,
so all of these, by the way, are for before you fly with your dog.
Yeah.
Stay tuned for the before, the during and after.
The before, during and after.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
I'm not done.
Hi.
So packing their
suitcase,
we decided not to actually use a real suitcase.
Prince and Pashas, not ours.
You pulled that on his head?
Yeah.
Jesus.
We decided to pack it in a box just because for domestic flights anyway, since I'm going to Mississauga to Vancouver, you're only allowed 23 kg or the kg. So suitcases alone, material is very heavy and we needed, like, you know, a lot for the dogs.
Yeah.
So we used a long cardboard box. That way, like, even if I had any leftovers, I could put inside. So that's another tip.
Yeah.
That's tip two, I think. Another very important tip is if you think you need pet passports for domestic flights, you don't. Well, I'm not sure about other airlines, but for Air Canada, you don't. So don't worry about pet passports or the 10-day checkup. Like, usually if you're traveling internationally, you need a 10-day checkup and show that thing. So don't worry about that. You don't need pet passport. You don't need that checkup. You should get them checked just to check if they can fly in the airplane.
Yeah.
But otherwise, they don't need a pet passport because pet passports are quite expensive. I think they cost like $124 per dog. And soft-sided carrier, and make sure you get your dog or cat or whatever animal you have like comfortable with that carrier before.
Yeah.
The first one, Prince of Pasha, absolutely loved that carrier. They were sleeping in it. They were playing in it. They loved it because it was really big and spacious. But then when we found out it was not the right requirement, height, length, width, we had to get one that was. And this one we got a week and a half ago, they hated it initially. So I got a soft bedding type thing underneath to put inside. And now they love it. They're sleeping in it. So get your dog used to their pet carrier at least 2 weeks before you fly. If you stay tuned, if you subscribe and you stay tuned, then you will hopefully see the vlog that I'll be vlogging tomorrow, because tomorrow is my flight with the pets in the plane and the process at the airport and afterwards. And also another video I'm hoping to make is their update on how Prince and Pasha are doing in Vancouver. So I hope you guys enjoy this Prince and Pasha series, and it's going to be a series I hope to keep.